CoreJava tutorials. So today the topic is operators. Operators is very very important concept because these kind of questions come up in your placements as well as this is a very important university question. So please concentrate on this because it might look to be very easy concept, but it is very tricky concept. So you need to have more concentration, like put all your knowledge about typecasting into the expressions, and then the operator priority has to be put in mind while evaluating an expression. So many things are there like you have to consider while using operators. So this concept is very very important. So let us right away get into what are the various kinds of operators that Java provides. The operators are mainly grouped into four types. The first is arithmetic, the second is bitwise, the third one is relational, and the fourth one is logical. Apart from these four major groups, there are some other operators that we use in the programming. So those are assignment operator, ternary operator, short circuit operators, and instance of operator, and string concatenation operator. Instance of operator, I'll be talking about this after we discuss classes and objects. Rest of the operators you'll be seeing in this video. And before that, we'll just see what is the definition of an operator. An operator is a symbol. I'm giving you the definition in the programming language. An operator in the programming language is a symbol that tells compiler or interpreter to perform specific mathematical, relational, logical operations and produce final result. So the operators will produce some result. Okay, when we apply operators on the operands, then it will produce some result. Let us see what are the various arithmetic operators. So these are the 12 arithmetic operators. These arithmetic operators are used in mathematical expressions in the same way like how we use them in algebra. So there is no difference. Okay, so let us straight away see what are the various arithmetic operators. So this operator is when used with the two operands, then it becomes the binary operator, but it can also be used as an unary plus. Okay, so I can simply say x is equal to 5. There is no need of 5 means that it is already plus 5, so you needn't put a prefix it with plus. Okay, so in what situations you generally prefix it with plus is maybe it is negative throughout the program and at some point it became positive. So to show that distinction, then you can use a plus in front of the value. Rather than that, there is no significance of it. Okay, so then other one is subtraction. Subtraction also can be used in the same way. I can say int x is equal to minus 5. So the negation of this particular value is stored. Okay, so this also is a binary operator when two operands are used, but it can also be used as a as an unary minus. Okay, so from here, okay, so till here, all these operators are binary operators. What does it mean by binary operator? Binary operator means that there will be two operands. Okay, so there will be an operand here and there will be another operand here. Okay, so it means like 5 plus 3. So 5 and 3 are called as operands. Okay, and this plus is called as operator. Okay, so when an operator takes two operands in the calculation, then it is called as a binary operator. So from here till here, okay, plus, minus, division, multiplication, division, modulus, then these are compound assignments. All these compound assignments, everything is a binary operator. Okay, and these two can also be used as unary, and the last two, like increment and decrement operators, these two are again unary operators. Okay, so there are some rules that you should know before applying these operators in an expression. So we'll see what are those rules. The first rule is that operands should be of a numeric type. Okay, so what are the numeric data types? Okay, so integral, Okay, so floating and also even char is of numerical type because it is a subset of integer. So integers, floatings and char, all these are considered to be numeric, and on all these three you can apply all these arithmetic operators. But you cannot perform these operations on Boolean data type. Okay, so you should be very careful because in your examinations, they'll give you some Boolean kind of expressions and tell whether this will evaluate or not. Okay, so and the next one is like these are some of the rules that conversions that happens when you are using this operator. Okay, so if the oper one to if both the operands are byte, then the expression's result will get converted to integer. Okay, so if there is one byte and short, again it gets converted to integer. Two shorts, it converts to integer. Okay, so long, then it converts to long. Now the formula is that the result of the expression will be max of, okay, so int comma the type of first operand comma the type of second operand. Okay, so say for example I'm having an expression which is 5 plus 8.2. Okay, so when I'm having this expression, 5 is of integer type and this is of floating type. So it will be max of int comma, the type of first operand is int comma and the type of second operand is float. So what is maximum? Float. So the result will be in a floating type. So you always have to keep this formula in mind so that you don't make mistakes in your programming. Okay, so keeping all this in mind, let us now see one example program. Okay, well friends, okay, so I have performed all the arithmetic operations in this program. Just take a look at it. Now I have declared a variable a which is of integer type, and I performed 4 plus 1, so the result is 5. So if I try to print a, the result will be 5. So a's value is 5. And then I have taken another variable b, wherein I said a into 2. Okay, so these are the two operands. So a's value is 5, 5 into 2 is 10. So when I try to print b, then the answer will be 10. So then again, I said like c is equal to b by 3. Now this is very important to be noted. Whenever you're performing division between two integers, then what will happen is the fractional part will be truncated. So be very careful in that. So what is the value of b? The value of b is 10. So 10 by 3 will be equal to some 3.33, so on. But what will happen is this fractional component will be truncated and the result will be only 3. So whenever you're doing division of int by int, then be very careful. This is one very important point that you need to remember with the division. The second thing that you need to remember with the division is that you should not divide a number by 0. Okay, so if you are dividing a number by 0, then generally in mathematics, any number divided by 0 is infinity. Okay, so in this Java programming, while to represent infinity, there is no number in integral part. So that's the reason whenever you try to perform any number divided by 0, you will get a runtime error. Okay, so your program will abruptly stop. So please avoid this kind of division by 0. Okay, but you can perform division by 0 with the floating values, but you cannot perform with the integer values. But if you are trying to do like this, like integer by int by double, and say int, I'm saying 10 by 0.0. So what will happen according to the conversion rules that I have told you in the introduction of arithmetic operators? I said like int by double will be converted to double, and there is a way to represent infinity in floating points. So that's the reason you won't get any error if you are trying to perform this. These are very very important interview questions and placement questions. Like they'll give this kind of questions and ask you to predict the output. So try to keep these points in mind with the division. Okay, so now what will be the answer if I try to perform division? It will be 3 because the fractional part is truncated. Then I said int d is equal to c minus a. What is the value of c? It is 3. 3 minus a is 5, so that is equal to minus 2. Then I said E is equal to, I am giving an unary minus over here. So minus D, okay, minus of minus 2, which will become plus 2, okay. So this is on the integral part. Now coming to the floating part, so what will happen, 4 plus 1 will be 5.0. So the answer will be like this with the with both integer type, integers, and then the fractional component, both the components will be there. Then I said this will be 10.0, and then here this division will automatically be double, because it's double by double will be double, max of that. So I'll be getting this, and then this will be minus 1.66, and when I convert it, it will be this. Okay, so this is regarding the doubles. And then coming to the chars, you can also apply arithmetic operations on the characters, but the internal Unicode integer value will be taken. So for capital A, the code is 65, and for capital B, it is 66. So when these two are added, then you get 131, okay? So when you try to print this C, the answer will be 131. Now, see, please make a note that I made it an integer. So you can just look into the conversion rules that I talked about. Char plus char will give you an integer. So you have to give an integer, else it will be a compilation error. Okay, so now we'll take a look at compound assignment operators. Okay, so the next operator is modulus operator. Okay, so this modulus operator will give you the remainder as result of the division operation. So it will give the remainder as the result, okay, so of the division operation. And if you are a C and C++ programmer, you might be wondering, like, I have performed modulus on doubles, on the floating values. Okay, so in C and C++, you cannot perform modulus operation on floats. But in Java, you can perform. So this is one very important point that you people need to keep in mind. Okay, so now we'll just take a look. I said int x is equal to 33. And double y is equal to 33.25. So if I just perform modulus operation of this, it will be 33 mod 10. So the remainder will be 3. Okay, so for the people who don't know the modulus, I'll just try to calculate it for you. 10 3s are 30. Okay, so when I subtract, I get 3. So this will be the result that it is giving. Okay, so this will be the result. So that it gives the remainder as the result. Okay, so in the same way, so when I perform modulus operation on the floating values, I'll get 3.25. So it is possible, like how you are performing modulus on integers, you can perform modulus on the floating points as well. Okay, so next is compound assignment operators. So we'll just take a look at them now. Okay, so these are all the various compound assignment operators, and the advantage of the compound assignment statements is that they save you a bit of typing. Okay, so rather than I'll just talk about that point, like say I'm saying A is equal to A plus 5. Okay, so I'm having a variable A, and I am performing addition of a 5 on the same variable. Now please try to make a note of this, that when you want to perform this addition on the same variable, and the result is again stored in the same variable. So when you are having such kind of expressions, you can use this compound assignments. Okay, so this is called as arithmetic assignment. This is called as subtraction assignment. This is multiplication assignment. This is division assignment. And this is modulus assignment. So the statement is like A is equal to A plus 5. You can rewrite this, okay, in this particular general form, like... So the general form of compound assignment. So we'll see what is the general form of compound assignment. The general form of compound assignment is variable. Okay, so then op is equal to expression. Okay, so this is the general form. What does it mean by variable? Variable is A over here. So this variable means A. Okay, operation. Okay, so what is the operation you are trying to perform? Plus. So I'm bringing plus over here. And then is equal to, and what is the expression, which is 5. So you can rewrite this in this particular form. And what did you do over here? You are saving a bit over by doing this expression. You are saving a bit. And also not only that, the implementation of this compound assignments is efficient inside your JVM. So if you just take a look at professional Java programs, you can find only these rather than this. So it is a very good practice that you take it, because these statements execute faster than these statements, because it is efficiently implemented inside the JVM. So we'll just try to see how this can be done. If I can just say this is it, this can be written like this. If I want to write a is equal to a minus 5, I can also write it in this manner. Okay, so then coming over here, if a is equal to a into 8, so if I have like this, I can say a into is equal to 8. Okay, so division, I can also say if I just have a by 10, okay, I can rewrite this as a is equal to 10. Okay, so in this manner I can write. Even modulus, if I'm having a is equal to a mod 3, okay, I can simply write a mod is equal to 3. Okay, so this is how you write it, and this statement is both are same, but what I am trying to tell you is try to use these, because this is very efficient efficiently implemented in JVM, and it is quite faster rather than the previous statement that I told you. The last two arithmetic operators are increment operator and decrement operator. Increment operator is generally given with the two plus symbols, and decrement operator is given with the two consecutive minus symbols. And what is meant by increment operator? Increment operator will increase the operand value, increase the operand value by 1. Okay, so decrement operator will decrease the operand value by 1. Okay, so operand value by 1. They exist in two forms. What are the two forms of increment and decrement operators? They exist as prefix forms, okay, and postfix forms. Okay, so it depends on where you are putting them. If you are putting before the operand, okay, say for example I am having an operand which is x. Okay, so if I am putting it before, then it is called as a prefix form. If I am putting it after, then it is called as a postfix form. This is called as pre-increment and this is called as a post-increment. Okay, so it depends on the position where you are putting it, and there is a meaning also for it. And in the same way, like with the decrement operator also, if you are putting it before the operand, then it is called as a pre-decrement, and if you are putting it afterwards, it's called as a post-decrement. Okay, so these are the forms of increment and decrement operator, and this increment and decrement operations can be performed on all primitive data types, except boolean. Okay, so except boolean, you can perform this on everything except boolean. Like I said here, boolean x is equal to true, and I said plus plus x, this is not possible, you will get compile time error. Okay, so you should not do like this. This can be applied on every primitive data type except on boolean data type. Okay, so we will try to understand these operations with an example. So let us see the first example. In the first example, I said x is equal to 23 and I said y is equal to plus plus x. Now try to pause the video and try to guess the values of x and y. What will be the value of x and what will be the value of y? Okay, fine. Since I have put this before the operand, what will happen is before assigning it to y, the value will increment. So x value will become 24, meaning that x will become x is equal to x plus 1, and then x will be assigned to y. So this will happen. So the operations performed here will be x is equal to x plus 1, and then x will be assigned to y, meaning that x has become 24 and then 24 is assigned to y. So what will be the values of x and y? The values of x will be 24 and also the value of y also will be 24. Okay, so it depends on the place where we are applying it. Okay, now come to this example. I said x is equal to 23 and y is equal to, this is post increment. So the increment should happen after assigning the value to y. So what happens here is now y will be assigned with the value of x, and then x will become x plus 1. X will become x plus 1. Okay, so what will be the values of x and y? Obviously, x value will be 24, but y value will be 23 itself, because after assigning it to y, we are asking it to increment. So this is regarding pre-increment and post-increment. In the similar way, you can apply this for decrement also. Okay, so say I am performing decrement on this particular same variable, and I am saying minus minus x. Okay, so now tell me what will be the value of x and y over here. Okay, so the value of x, now what does it mean? This means that it is a pre-decrement. So x will become x minus 1, and then x value will be assigned to y. So what will be the value of x? The value of x will be 22, and the value of y also will be 22. Okay, we'll try to see what will happen to x and y values if we apply post decrement. Okay, so I said x is equal to 23, y is equal to x minus minus. Now what will happen is, since we are applying this decrement operator after this, so first x will be assigned to y, and then x value will become x minus 1. So these will be the sequence of steps that will execute for this particular statement. So what will be the value of x and y? The value of x will be 22, because 23 minus 1 is 22, and the value of y will be 23 itself, because after assigning x value to y, then it has decremented. So hope you understood increment and decrement operations, my friends, because these are very important for your placements and some quiz exams if you are trying to attempt. Okay, so the next one is, like I said, y is equal to plus plus 20. Now, you can just pause the video and try to guess what will be the output of this particular statement. Okay, so this is absolutely wrong. You cannot apply increment and decrement operations on the constants. Okay, so you cannot apply it on them. You can only apply increment and decrement operators only on the variables. You cannot apply it on the constant. So you'll get an error over here. And the next very important thing is, like I have declared x to be of a final type. Okay, so if it is simply an integer type, then there is no problem. But I said it is of a final type. So final type cannot change throughout your program. And if you are trying to say x plus plus or plus plus x or whatever you are trying to do over here, will result in compilation failure. So you cannot apply increment and decrement operations on the final variables. Okay, so this is all about increment and decrements. Like, you can apply it on all primitive data types except booleans, and there are two forms, prefix form and postfix form, pre-increment and post-increment, pre-decrement and post-decrement, and then the various things that I have discussed here in the examples. Okay friends, so this is all about arithmetic operators. Hope this video is worth watching. Stay home, stay safe, happy learning, bye.